As we all know, Android is a powerful operating system, and as of now, Android 13 is the latest release of its kind available in the market. Now going back past a decade, Android was newly released and didn't have so many features and customizations just like now. In this video, I'm gonna give a close look up of the Android One user experience. So without wasting any time, let's get started. For this demonstration, I'll be using VMware Workstation Player 17 to run the ISO file. Unfortunately, the ISO file isn't subjected to public rights. So what I did was that rent an old faintly working Android device from a grandpa aged person who is the owner of a Xerox shop and extract the firmware into a flash drive and burnt it into an ISO file. Now I'm gonna give the ISO file for free, but if you would just support this small content creator by subscribing to this channel, it would mean a lot to me. While booting up the ISO file, mount it to the primary SDA partition and format it to ext3 file system, and be sure to install the grub bootloader. Here is the boot splash logo of the first Android operating system. It actually didn't mean to boot so fast, but due to the fact that I have assigned 4GB of RAM to this virtual machine, so it did. The default wallpaper of this operating system definitely gives us a nostalgic feeling of the old days. As here you can see that this firmware is based on Android 1.6 and the kernel version is 2.6.29. If you have noticed, there's a text Android x86 written inside the kernel version column. It doesn't mean the project of Android x86, but does mean to say that this operating system has an x86 Android support kernel. The internet works perfectly, but some of the raw assets won't load as they have been obsolete under Android 5.1. Some security dialogues do pop up as the version of the default browser is at a far distance from the last supported release. There is also a snake game that can be played by pressing the arrow keys of the keyboard. Mm-hmm. It's showing that the operating system is updating but will never happen so as the repositories of his patch files are not maintained anymore. Here it is clearly written that your device is no longer supported. Please update to Android 4.0 or above to use YouTube. My internet connection is fast enough to load at least web pages, but the Instagram page would also not load. It loads the header text, but the contents do not show up. I tried with more than 5 email IDs with 2-step verification turned off, but it won't just sign in. So that's it for this video. Thanks for watching. Have a good day. Bye.